again we are starting with your 10th chapter, lesson 10. Yes, a small one. Let us write everything. It's very easy, simple. From book perspective, it becomes a little complicated. I'll write and explain, maintain the notes for this. Lesson 10. Intercorporate loans, comma investments, comma guarantees, and security. Intercorporate loans, investments, guarantees, and security. Before starting this chapter, let us know what is this chapter. Now the law say, whenever there is a company, whenever the company wants to do four things, whenever the company wants to give a guarantee to another company, what do you mean by guarantee? Assume this company is going and taking a loan from another company. The company is guaranteeing that loan, meaning tomorrow if you do not pay, I will repay that loan on behalf of you. Guarantee. If the company is giving a guarantee, if the company is making an investment in this company, Company A is making or giving a guarantee or giving a making an investment. Investment in what? In securities of investment in securities of Company B. It can be equity, it can be debentures, it can be any instrument. You are basically investing. Yes, okay. Or you are giving loan to Company B, or you are giving any other security. You are giving any other security to that Company B. In these four cases, going forward, we will be referring this as gilts. Guarantee, investment, loan, security. If one company is giving these to any other person, yeah, section 186 shall apply. What does 186 say? Whenever the money is going out from your account in form of guarantee, investment, loan, security, then you have to comply with section 186. Okay, sir. Got a fair idea why we are seeing this section? We have not yet got into detail. But what we will be discussing is this. When one company is giving a guarantee, investment, loan, security to a person, section 186 will apply. That is this chapter. In detail, we'll be seeing. Section 186, very important. Okay, before we start, sir, does this thing apply to anyone? No. This applies to everyone except these people. Who? The people who are exempted from Section 186 are non banking financial company. Engaged in defense production, that is, they are engaged in the production of defense related equipment. Other than listed company and obtains approval of Department of Government. So government company, if you are engaged in a defense production, this section is not applicable to you. If you are not a listed company and if you take government's approval, it is not applicable to you. The last one, investment company. What do you mean by investment company? Whose main objects is to hold, comma, acquire or dispose securities. Or a company having any other object but income from investment is more than 50% of its total income, or value of investment is more than 50% of total value of assets. Yeah, it is not applicable to a banking company, insurance company, housing finance company, any finance company which will give finance to industrial or infrastructural projects. Investments made in shares allotted under rights issue. What do you mean by this? We are talking from A company's point of view. It has already invested in B company in equity shares. Now B company is doing a rights issue. What do you mean by rights issue? Every existing shareholder will get a right to invest in more shares of the company. Like that only they gave one letter of offer to A company. Now if A company is investing in this B company with respect to that rights issue made, then yes, this is not applicable. It is not applicable to an NBFC company. It is not applicable to an investment in wholly owned subsidiary. What do you mean by wholly owned subsidiary? There is a A company. It is invested in B company. it is holding 100% of capital in B company, then the provision from this company to this company, whatever it is, that investment from A to B, 186 is not applicable. 186 is not applicable between holding company and wholly owned subsidiary. Government company engaged in defense production, that is, you are into manufacturing of any equipment related to the defense strategies, whatever the defense thing is related, for them the section is not applicable. And if you are an unlisted company and you take central government's approval, then it is not applicable. By default, it is applicable to government company. Only these two it is not applicable. Investment company. What is an investment company? Basically, a company who in its main objects has the main object as investments. That is, we acquire, hold and dispose of securities. Listen, whenever A wants to invest in securities of B, it can be debentures, it can be equity, it can be preference, or it wants to give loan, whatever it is. Yeah. I'll come to that. Sulochana, listen, if A wants to invest in B, whether in debentures, equity, preference, loan, section 186 will apply. However, assume A was already a shareholder of B. A is already a shareholder of B. B is now further raising capital. They want further money. Now B is doing rights issue. That is 62(1)(a). What is 62(1)(a)? Whoever are your existing shareholders, you give them a right to subscribe to the shares of the company. So in the same way, B has given A a right to subscribe to the shares of a company, and A chooses to invest through that rights issue. In this method, 186 is not applicable. First time it applies. If B is doing through private placement, it applies. Any other way it applies. If it is doing through rights issue, not applicable. Another one. Thomas. If A and B, B is a wholly owned subsidiary. Your doubt is, assume if C is investing in B, is 186 applicable? Is that your question? 186 is applicable. It is only between these two people. And B cannot invest in A. You remember, a subsidiary company cannot invest in holding company. So that question does not arise at all. You remember, we have discussed that. The last one, investment company. What do you mean by investment company? Whose main object is to invest? Your MOA says that you are here to invest. Or you are having any other object, but your income from investment is more than 50% of your total income. What do you mean by this? Listen carefully. ABC company, they sell, say for example, pen. They sell pens and they have earned 5 lakh rupees. In the year 2019-20. In the same year, they had extra money also, which they had invested in other investments. They had invested in equity shares. They had invested in debentures. They had invested in preference shares. All these together, they got interest. They got dividend, they got preference dividend, because they have invested the extra money in other companies' shares, debentures, preferences. Basically, these were investments, and assume they earned a return of 6 lakh rupees. Now their total income for the year 2019 and 2020 is 11 lakh. In your total income, if more than 50% of your income is through investments, then even you will be considered as an investment company. Your regular income is there, your total income is there. In that, more than 50% you are earning through investments, then you will be called as investment company. Or assume in your balance sheet you have invested in land 1 lakh, you have invested in plant and machinery 1 lakh, bank 1 lakh, investments, say 6 lakh, total asset side is 9 lakh. In the asset side, if your total investments of your total assets, if investments are more than 50% of your total assets, your total assets is 9 lakh. Of that, 50% is 4,50,000. It is more than that. Whatever is in investments, you have invested in other places, even then you will be considered as an investment company. That is what they are planning. They are trying to explain here. You are having any other object, but income from investment is more than 50% of total income, or value of investment is more than 50% of total value of assets. Are you getting the point? Understood these two criterias? So for all these people, section 186 does not apply. Okay, sir. Now, what does this section say? If any company provides what? Gilts. You guys know better what is gilts now. Guarantee, investment, loan, security. If any company provide guarantee, investment, loan, security. To any person or body corporate, then section 186 shall apply. And care to be taken, I am talking from the company which is giving, not from which is taking. We are talking about a company which is giving. Yeah. So, if any company which provides guarantee, investment, loan, security to any person or body corporate, section 186 shall apply. Here, the word person does not include an individual who is in employment of the company. Yes? Now, before going to the second point, now, whenever the money is going out from your pocket, that is in the form of gilts, yeah, there are three types of approvals which you need to take. Three types of approvals depending on the case basis. Depending on the case to case. Sir, now I want to invest, I want to give loan, I want to give guarantee. Whose approval I have to take? First one, board approval. Wherever it is board resolution, mandatory to pass. Second one, special resolution. I'm putting star. Why? I'll tell you. The third one is called as public financial institution. PFI. Again, I am putting a star. Board resolution mandatory. Depending on the each case, PFI, public financial institution. Very interesting provision, listen. Sir, okay. Board approval. Sir, why is that star mark written on special resolution? Listen carefully. Copied this one. Yes. Done. They have given a limit under section 186. Limit under section 186. What is the limit? A company can give loan up to 60% of paid up share capital plus free reserve plus securities premium. Securities premium or hundred % of free reserve plus securities premium. Sixty % of paid up share capital, free reserves plus security premium, or 100% of free reserve plus security premium, whichever is higher. So the law say any time if you want to give a loan, investment, guarantee, security, the maximum you can give, take your paid up share capital, free reserve, security premium, add everything into 60% of it. Whatever the amount comes, that is the maximum you can do gilts, or 100% of your free reserve plus security premium. That is the maximum you can do. Sir, what if I want to go beyond that? Sir, what if I want to go beyond that? Now your star marks come into picture. If company wants to exceed the above limits, that is shareholders' approval. Yes. So indirectly, what are they telling? So write down summary for your ease of understanding. Summary, what does it say? Limit under section 186. Existing plus new. What do you mean by new? The new proposed investments they want to make. So that 60% and 100% is not for a fresh investment. If you have already made guarantee, if you have already issued loan, that plus new, which you want to do, you have to add and take. It's not for every investment. Together in the life of the company, if at all you're exceeding more of those two limits. So existing plus new. Yeah, existing plus new, what? Gilts. existing plus new guilds is within limits, then pass board resolution is exceeding limit, then what? Pass board resolution and special resolution. So if any company at any given point of time, they want to give guarantee, loan, investment, security. Assume in the previous year, the company has already given loan of 50 lakhs in the previous year. Now they want to freshly give. So you want to first calculate how much is their paid up capital. Assume if it is 20 lakhs, what is their free reserve? Assume 10 lakhs. Assume how much is security premium account, 5 lakh. Add everything. How much is coming? 35 lakh. 35 lakh into 60% or 10 lakh, that is free reserves plus security premium, 5 lakh. So 15 lakh into 100%. Yeah, can you do someone 35 lakh into 60%? 21 lakh. So 21 lakh or 15 lakh. Yes, whichever is higher. That is what you can do. So the company can maximum give 21 lakh. However, we have assumed the company already has given 50 lakh loan to an outsider. They are exceeding the limit. Can you see? So you have to consider the old plus how much you want to give now. If it is exceeding this limit now, you have to pass board resolution plus special resolution. Understood, not understood? Okay, did you guys understand till now? Here, till this 21 lakh calculation, understood? All of you, till 21 lakh calculation, did you understand? Forget about that 50 lakh. This is paid up capital. This is free reserve. This is security premiums account. Yes, now the limit is 21 lakh. Assume if the company wants to give a loan to an outsider of 15 lakh, the company can give a loan without asking shareholders just by passing board resolution. Sir, what if they want to give 25 lakh? It is exceeding the limit. Pass board resolution. Also, you have to take shareholders' approval. Understood this point? Yes. Now, assume, sir, what if the company already in the previous year, it has already given 5 lakh loan to someone. Now what to do? Now, whatever this 21 lakh, the limit, it is for existing plus new. You cannot exceed that. Yes. Now assume our limit was 21 lakh, correct? Assume if the company is planning to issue 17 lakh loan. Let us take two scenarios. In the first scenario, you don't have any previous loan you have given. Yeah. You want to give 17 lakhs now. Board resolution alone is sufficient. Assume second scenario. Our maximum limit is 21 lakh. We have calculated. The company in the previous year, they have already given 5 lakh loan to an outsider. They have already given 5 lakh loan. Yes. Now, again in this year, a new person is asking 17 lakh loan. Yes. Now tell me, is special resolution required or not required? This is previous year. That is already existing loan which a company already has given. This is a current year. That is a fresh loan. It is required. How? You have to take it 17 lakh plus 5 lakh. Both of this together, if it is exceeding the limit, you have to take special resolution. So what I am trying to tell you, this 21 lakh is not for every approval. It is for the overall loan which can be given by the company. It is for all the previous years plus this year, loan, investment, guarantee, security, everything put together, everything. So you have to take it as G plus investment plus loan plus security equals this limit. All of you understood? Did you get a clarity on this?